long run. So at the end of the motherfucker day, G, it's like this, man. What? I don't know what the fuck you talking about, but at the end of the day, G, it's like this, bro. If you a boss, bro, and you getting money, bro, ain't no way in hell out here you should be doing dumbass worker shit. Ain't no way in hell you should be out here doing dumbass worker shit. Ain't no way in hell you should be out here doing dumbass nigga shit. Like, at the end of the day, I like the Dirk, man. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't got no discrimination against the BDs, G. If other niggas that I fuck with don't like the BDs, then that's on them. I might don't like a couple of them, but that don't go for all BDs. I like the Dirk, man. Dirk was doing this motherfucker thing, putting out good quality music, bro. But when Dirk got them and got with Von, and he started letting Von gas him up, and niggas started feeling they motherfucking self because that street shit started to happen again. Look what he did. Dirk fucked himself up. Dirk fucked himself up. He ain't give a fuck about India. Dirk ain't give a fuck about India. He ain't give a fuck about his kids. He ain't give a fuck about motherfucker Buka. He ain't give a fuck about motherfucking none of the people that he had up under his motherfucker team. None of the OTL. Because ain't no way to hell a boss supposed to be outside robbing a nigga for $30,000 in cash and a motherfucking chain. Dirk got more than that shit, man. That was the dumbest move ever to do. And then to rap about that shit. On me, that shit crazy. That shit crazy as hell, G. On some real shit. That shit crazy. I ain't even gonna lie to you. That shit crazy. Then the other shit that pissed me off about this shit, you got motherfuckers like Lil Reese. Lil Reese who out here, the Grand Reaper. We never call Lil Reese the Grand Reaper. You had motherfuckers like DJ Academic call motherfucking Lil Reese the motherfucking Grand Reaper. You had motherfuckers that gassed Lil Reese up because he came out with all the shit with Chief Keef and them. At the end of the day, y'all never seen Lil Reese blow no pistol. Y'all never seen Lil Reese kill no motherfucking body. So for y'all to give motherfucker a name and y'all to give motherfuckers unnecessary attention, eventually you're going to have some niggas come your motherfucker way that want to get on your ass. Eventually you're going to have some niggas that want to come get on your ass and want to see what this shit is about. And that's what happened right now today. Lil Reese were about, man, fucking 95 pounds. Ain't no way in hell Lil Reese should have got caught lacking, bro. Ain't no way in hell you're going to get caught lacking without your tool. Where your niggas at? Where your homies at? Where your niggas at? Them niggas supposed to have been helping them out, man. If they wanted that to help him out, then he supposed to been blasting the nigga. But at the end of the day, that let you know Lil Reese ain't who he say he is. If you move around to Chicago by yourself, man, you got to know how to move through that bitch. On my kids, if you move around Chicago by yourself, you better keep that motherfucker on you. You better keep a gun on you, some pepper spray. You better keep something on you. Whatever the fuck you do, you better do something to protect yourself, bro. On kids. So at the end of the day, motherfucker want to talk about this man a Grand Reaper. Now they got this man all on the internet shitting on this motherfucker self. Come on, man. Is you serious? Is you serious? Like, I be trying to learn y'all and tell y'all something. These people don't be really who they say they is, man. Straight up. Straight up. They really don't be who they say they is. Look at Youngboy. I love Youngboy music. Youngboy got herpes. Youngboy beat up girls. Youngboy got the credit for killing G-Money. Ain't had nothing to do with that shit. Like, come on, man. Come on, man. The real always win. The real always win. All y'all's around this bitch talking about we not from 63rd. Now y'all gonna be talking about y'all from 63rd. Cause y'all finna be dick riding duck. The OT way, the OTFF, the OTF way gone. Like, who finna hold it down? You know what I'm saying? Niggas be more trying to tear each other down than help each other out. And my mama, that was some dumb ass shit that he did, Polly. You know that was some dumb ass shit for. What he doing that for? You got out of Chicago, you got out of the trenches. What is you doing that for? What is you doing that for? Right now we talking about Dirk. What is you doing that for? On God, like, what are you doing that for, bro? You straight. You got everything going on. What is you doing that for? That was the dumbest shit ever. I never understood why the fuck people get rich and then start doing dumb ass shit. But you know what made me understand this shit right now, TCB? What made me understood this shit right now, bro, is that they never lived that life. They never lived that life. They never was about that shit. And at the end of the day, after a while, when you getting money and you never lived that life and you watched all these movies, you want to jump off the porch and try to do that shit. You want to try to live that shit. You want to try to get out here and do that shit. Dirk went to jail to a minimum motherfucking prison in fucking Chicago, and that was Vandalia. That bitch was on lockdown. Straight up. Straight up. Yeah, DJ Academic, Golden Boy, he pumped all these niggas up. DJ Academic a bitch, because he pumped up Lil Reese, he pumped up motherfucking Dirk, And at the end of the motherfucking day, he pumped up Chief Keef. But this is what I'm going to tell you. Chief Keef was the smartest out of all of them. Chief Keef knew he got his bag, and the shit that he's going through is because of what he's going through. Ain't no niggas in Chicago fucking real savages, bro. Like, Furtis Wise just out here just killing people, knocking their shit off, bro. Niggas ain't out here just, like, really killing motherfuckers out here. Niggas in Chicago are some real niggas, bro. Niggas in Chicago is bona fide hustlers, G. It's just the end of the day, niggas, the life that they live, the shit that be going on in these streets, bro. That's how niggas get into it and shit be happening. It don't really be, oh, just motherfuckers just sitting up here born into this shit. You gotta, oh, instantly got a bounty in your head. You gotta carry a gun. You gotta go through training. This ain't motherfucking Afghanistan. This ain't over fucking seas, man. Straight up.